Good morning guys, and today our topic is current transformer and the potential transformer, that is called PT. One is CT, that is called current transformer, and another is for your PT for potential transformer. So first of all, we have to ask three questions: what and how and why. Okay, so what means CT? Means CT from the name, you can and get this is current transformer. So why it is required? First, we have to another question: why it is required? Look, whenever we I am going for the next page. Look, this is the picture of some CT. Okay, so why it is required? Whenever we going for the current measurement for your higher level of current, just like above 100 ampere, when you say this is your line, distribution line, your high tension line, there you can't measure this 100 like ampere. Even above 15 ampere, even above 15 ampere, it is not possible directly to measure in your small ammeter or voltmeter. Our digital ammeter and voltmeter, it is working with only 5 volt DC. So it is not possible to measure some ampere, 1 ampere range or more than that. But in case of your analog ampere, you can easily measure are up to some 60, 64 ampere at least. But and you have seen already 100 ampere in your powerhouse or any distribution board. But how is it possible? Because your coil, you know, that is made of generally MI type instrument or PMMC type instrument, but we are dealing with the AC current. That's why I hear PMMC not applicable. So only MI type or dynamometer type instruments are there. But this is only made of some coil. Okay. So if you thin wire coil or some current coil is somewhat, this is thick, but this is not enough thick to carry this 100 ampere. How is it possible? But you can say that is some shunt or series is there. No, this is only capable of above 15 ampere, it can endure. But above this, if you go for the 64, 32, this like of ampere, then you have to need some current transformer. What is the purpose of this current transformer? Actually, current transformer reduce the current level, this 100 ampere level, to say this is the 10 ampere, yeah, 100 to the 1 ampere level. So this is identical with this one. 100 ampere is just identical to 1 ampere. So if this is a 97 ampere, then it will be swinging 0.97 ampere. So our measuring instrument, just like MI type instrument and dynamometer type instrument, can easily measure this 0.97 ampere or at least 1 ampere, or it may be up to the 5 ampere. So whenever we can measure this 5 ampere or like 8 ampere, then we can easily change the scale up to this higher range, say 100 ampere, say 97 ampere. So in this way, if we calibrate in this way, yes, so we can measure this 100 ampere or 97 ampere. So this is the main causes behind this CT and your PT, because the higher range, very high voltage, is not able to measure by this your instrument. Like this type of your measuring instrument. Even you have seen some tong type tester, just like tester you have seen in, okay, whatever I am drawing, this type of testing, tong tester or some clamp on meter type. There. So this is done only by this CT type instrument. And now this is a question: what is the working principle? Guys, have you any question? This is the main statement or reason behind this is CT and the PT. Now how it is working, or what is the construction, then it is how it is working. Look, this is the transformer. So the main working principle is based on your transformer action. Look, whenever we are using some transformer, there is a primary coil and there is a secondary coil. Okay, say this is a primary coil, means where we apply some input. Okay, so whenever some AC current is flowing through this primary coil, whenever AC current is flowing through this primary coil, in each and everywhere, there is some magnetic field surrounding this wire. That's why it is producing some flux. Okay, as this is a coil, this is formed a coil, so flux are guided in a parallel way. That's why it is creating a flux. But whenever we stretch this wire in a straight line, what happens? What about the flux distribution? Look, whenever a current is flowing through a wire or conductor, then surrounding this area, a flux is creating, a magnetic field is creating. Just like this, you can see, just like this, a magnetic field is creating. And you may ask me, is that exist? Or you may say something absurd. Then my answer is, just remember the Ampere swimming rules. Yeah, you may put some magnetic needle just beneath this magnetic conducting wire. Then this magnetic magnetic needle will deflect. Okay. I think this type of experiment you have performed in your 10 plus or 12 plus. Okay, so if a current carrying conductor is carrying some current, maybe DC or maybe AC, and if you closed a magnetic needle just near to this conducting wire, then suddenly this magnetic needle will deflect. Means it will try to rotate. Why it is try to rotate? Because at the surrounding area of this wire, it creates some magnetic field, and this magnetic field is reacting with the magnetic field produced by the magnetic needle. And as this wire is fixed, then this magnetic needle will deflect. So now if you think that only magnetic field can deflect or react with another magnetic field. So the field is at the surrounding of this wire, it must be a magnetic field. So that's why this is called an electromagnetic field, because electric current is flowing through this wire, and that's why a magnetic field is created. And this is certainly a magnetic field, because only a magnetic field can react with another magnetic field. A magnetic field not react with any chemical, any heat, or any other things. Okay, so this is the main fact. So each and every wire, every single wire, create a magnetic field. That's why it is creating a flux. If you sum this magnetic field, then it creating a branch of flux. Just like this. In your primary coil, look, each and every turn create a magnetic field. Just like this, here it is creating a magnetic field, here it is creating a magnetic field, this turn also creating a magnetic field. It every direction is defined. Say you can see the direction of this magnetic field is defined. So if we add all this field, then it will create a one flux. And this type of flux is parallel with each other, because every cut section, every small cut section create a magnetic field surrounding this area, and it is directed, not haphazard way. Okay, the direction depends on the number of turn and the AC supply. Okay, time of instant of AC supply. So every turn, if cross section area create a magnetic field, and this field, if you add one by one, then you can get a one flux is creating throughout this coil. So just I want to say this because I want to just show you this thing, that if this wire is not at the coil form, so what happens? If this is not the coil is not a wire is not at a coil form, then the surrounding field is creating around this type of round shape. It is creating a magnetic field. Okay, so whenever only 1 or 2 ampere is flowing through a conducting wire, the magnetic strength is say something x unit. But whenever 100 ampere current is flowing through a conducting wire, then what happens? Then the magnetic field will be much high, say 1x100. The magnetic strength is x100, so it will create huge strength of this magnetic field. That is the main sensing area, sensing elements of the CT. Look, whenever this current is flowing, the 100 ampere are just like 64 ampere or 32 ampere. Then what happens? A surrounding field of this conducting wire will create a magnetic field just like this. And this magnetic field is AC in nature. Only look, here is a question. Is CT work in a DC? No, in DC circuit, it's CT can't work. Okay, and PT also work only the AC, because the changing in nature, it required transformer or action, the Faraday's law of electromagnetism. A conducting wire must be exert at a change of magnetic field, then it will induce EMF. Okay, so as this is AC, so the magnetic field will be changed in nature. So if you put some another conducting element, just like ferromagnetic element, but it is insulated, then what happens? A flux is induced this coil, a flux is induced this type of core. Say I am putting some core material which is used in your transformer, some slotted core material is putting, what happens? Some the frequency, also the magnetic flux will be induced in this core material, and another coil is just coiled over this core material. So what happens? Again, magnetic flux is changing in nature through this coil. This is coil, CT coil. Okay, then CT will induce an EMF, but this EMF if has the same frequency, but the amount of EMF is depends on the number of turns. As you know, there is a number of turns is varies the induced EMF. In your CT or PT current, in your any transformer, if you put some high turn and of secondary, then it will induce high voltage. If you put some low number of turns, then it will induce low voltage. Just like this, but here this is the number of turns is just cover this core, and then it will induce some EMF. Look, so this is the main isometric relation is there. That is, if you put some 100, then this CT coil induce 1 ampere. If you put some 97 ampere, then it will induce 0.97 ampere. If you say flow some 64 ampere, then it will show only it will induce only 0.64 ampere. So here is a ratio, because ratio is depends on the number of turns. So we have to arrange the number of turns just like this, so that high ampere would be reduced up to this measurable current. Then this measurable current, this induced current is measurable by your or any analog ammeter or your digital ammeter. So in this way, we can measure the high amount of current arranged through this CT. I think, guys, if you get any question from this topic, you may ask me. Have you any question? Yes. Then I will explain again. So now I am going to the just go to the previous loop. This is the shape of this, the picture of city, and now this is the construction of this city. Look, here a primary current, or you may say this is the normal loaded current, it is flowing through this, is conducting wire. This is the high tension wire. Okay, so whenever this high tension wire is placed here, then you can't measure this current by this normal conventional ammeter, because this ammeter is made of MI type, means normal coil L, and or maybe some dynamometer instrument that is also made of some coils, thin wire coils. So this thin wire of coils can endure some high amount of current, just like a 100 ampere. So what should we do? We have to reduce this current and up to a measurable unit. So we have to convert this into a measurable unit. This is done by this is current transformer. You have just seen, if a current is flowing through a conductor, then it creates a magnetic field surrounding this area. This is just like this, you know, or in a just 90 degree angle. Okay, current is flowing, the magnetic field is creating in this manner. Okay, Fleming's rules, as per this Fleming rules. Okay, so whenever this magnetic field is created surrounding this conducting wire, then what happens? If you place a core material, means a ferromagnetic material, what happens? If a magnet is come near to the ferromagnetic material, then it will try to induce this ferromagnetic material into a magnet temporarily, because it will induce the opposite polarity at the face. So just like this, it will also induce a magnetic material, ferromagnetic to the magnetic material into this area. It behaves like a magnet, but as this is a AC current, the frequency is 50 hertz, then it will also change. So this core material became a magnetic material at this moment, but the frequency change of direction is 50 hertz, or the as per the applied frequency, because the flux is same, just like induced in this way. And now if we apply the Faraday's law of electromagnetic induction, then you can find if a conducting wire come to the field and a change of field, magnetic field, then what happens? The EMF is induced in this coil. Okay, so just assume this core became a magnetic material. It is produced some magnetic flux, because all the flux are flowing through this core area. You can see the arrow side, and it is changing in nature because we apply some AC, not DC. If you apply DC, then it will not work. And then what happens? So change of magnetic nature is available here, and a current carrying conducting is there. So what happens? A flux linkage with this coil, with this current carrying conductor coil, generally it is made of copper, or sometimes it is made of aluminium. Okay, if the weight is very high, volume is high, then we have to apply aluminium. But if the volume is less, then we can apply copper coil. Generally copper coil is prescribed, but due to reduce some weight, then we have to apply the aluminium coil. Okay, this is the main fundamental things. So what happens? This carrying conductor coil is also induced some EMF, but the EMF ratio, induced EMF, is just proportional to this number of turn ratio. So this, if you 100 ampere is flowing through this main wire, main conducting wire, then it will EMF is induced, say 1 ampere. It is calibrated it as per this your number of turns. So if we need to know this is 100 ampere, we have to place this is 10 ampere, then we have to increase or we have to settle this number of turns so that we get 100 ampere. This is depends on as per the measurement. Okay, so you can see that is 100 ampere is just identical with the EMF induced in this coil, that is 1 ampere, say 1 ampere. Generally we are dealing with 1 ampere. Or you may say this is flowing at least 80 ampere, then what will induce the induced EMF or whatever we are getting the ampere, this is 0.8 generally. If it is produced some 64 ampere, then it will produce 0.64. So if we can measure 0.64 ampere, then we can say this is a 64 ampere is flowing to the main wire. This is the fundamental things of this CT. So if your ampere, look, a general analog ampere is attached to this coil and it is measuring 0.8 ampere. So then we can understand the main current carrying conductor or transmission line is carrying 80 ampere because the trans ratio is 100:1. Okay, in this way we can arrange this. So if it is flowing, your ampere is showing, ammeter is showing 0.64 ampere, then you can say your current carrying conductor is carrying 64 ampere. So easily you can measure the high amount of current which is flowing through your current carrying conductor or your transmission line or somewhere your distribution line. Distribution line carry less current and then your transmission line carry high amount of current. And so in this way we can measure this 64, 80 or above 100 ampere. Okay, so this is the main fundamental things of current transformer. Now you can find the answer of this another question, where it is used. It is used in your distribution line. It is used in your transmission line also to measure the current carrying conductor. But not only there, it is also applicable in your normal tongue type tester. You have seen so many tongue type multimeter or clamp, it is called, somehow it is called clamp on multimeter. The science behind this ammeter is also based on this CT. Look, in this tongue, actually the arm of this tongue actually a core material. It is forming a core, and in this core there is a coil at this position, just like this diagram. At this position, whenever you clamp a high amount carrying conductor, say this is the current carrying conductor, say 10 ampere, in your distribution panel you can find there is some wire which is generally carrying 15 ampere, 32 ampere, or somewhere this is PDB powerhouse, you can find there is a 64 ampere. Okay, up to this it is allowable to measure this. After that you never go for any measurement because it is not in your hand. Then you have to open all the